In this week's space startup news, Starpath raises money for lunar ice mining. Second, Astrobotic preparing to test a lunar grid on the moon. Third, PLD Space and D-Orbit sign a launch agreement. And lastly, InnoSpace, a South Korean launch company, is preparing to launch its first orbital rocket from Brazil. Okay, let's get started. Starpath raises $12 million for lunar ice mining. Starpath, a startup working on lunar harvesting, extraction, and processing, has raised $12 million in funding. The company's plan extends beyond just digging up and processing lunar material, though. It plans to construct a power plant, fleet of rovers, and a processing facility as part of its lunar harvesting vision. This fresh capital will kickstart the construction of a demonstration system on Earth, allowing Starpath to test and refine its technology. On the moon, the company intends to harvest lunar material across a 20-kilometer radius using autonomous rovers. A thermal processing plant will operate continuously, melting ice, splitting the resulting water into hydrogen and oxygen, and then liquefying and storing these gases. Starpath's business model is straightforward. Sell vast quantities of liquid oxygen propellant to companies like SpaceX and Blue Origin. Both firms have secured NASA contracts to develop the human landing system, which will ferry crew to the lunar surface under the Artemis program. For example, a starship on the moon can hold 1,000 tons of liquid oxygen in its tanks. Beyond the technical hurdles and the unpredictability of lunar operations, Starpath's success rests on its potential customers and their key backer, the US government. We'll keep you posted on their progress. Next up, more lunar news. Astrobotic preparing to test a lunar grid demo on the moon. Astrobotic, a space startup based in Pittsburgh that is building lunar landers, is set to launch its Griffin lander later this year. This will be the largest NASA contracted lunar lander to date. Astrobotic is already thinking about how to use a lander to provide power for future missions, rovers, and equipment. John Thornton, the CEO of Astrobotic, explains, "If you have power at the poles of the moon, where everyone wants to go, missions can last for years on the surface rather than weeks." Astrobotic is developing LunaGrid, a solar power grid for the moon, which Thornton estimates can be built and deployed for under $500 million. The system will feature solar arrays positioned at a high point on the lunar pole, basking in near constant sunlight, paired with batteries to store energy for periods of shadow. Rovers extending from a central hub, unrolling power cables to deliver electricity to shadowed regions. The company plans to test this technology in 2028 with its Lunar Grid Light demo. This trial will see a rover travel 500 meters from a lander, transmitting power back and forth to prove the concept. Thornton believes a ready market exists among national space agencies for a lunar power grid. Beyond that, he views lunar power generation as a tipping point for a range of lunar business ventures. He argues that reliable power is necessary for activities like mining or extended exploration. One of the hardest things when looking at the moon is if you are limited to only a week or two of operations. It's hard to make the business case close, he said. If it cost $10 million to get there, you'd have to make $1 million a day. That changes when you can last for years. It opens up a whole new world because the price point of operating on the surface of the moon would drop dramatically. Okay, on to our next space story this week. PLD Space and D-Orbit team up for Equatorial missions. PLD Space, a Spanish space startup developing a family of launchers, has struck a deal with D-Orbit, a space logistics firm, to deploy satellites into equatorial orbit on board its Mura 5 rocket. This agreement pushes PLD Space's launch manifest to 80% capacity through 2027. PLD Space has secured a launch pad at Europe's primary spaceport in Kourou, French Guiana, a site perfectly positioned for low inclination and equatorial orbits. Few space startups, whether European or American, boast access to such a facility. While Ariane 6 and Vega rockets currently serve this niche, their infrequent flights, typically just a handful each year, leave room for PLD Space to tap into an underserved market. D-Orbit brings its Ion space tug to the partnership. Ion acts as a last-mile delivery service, guiding satellites to their precise final orbits. With 17 successful missions already under its belt, D-Orbit's expertise ensures this collaboration will deliver equatorial and low inclination options to its customers. Equatorial orbits shine for weather monitoring, particularly for tracking tropical storms and hurricanes that cluster near the equator. Satellites in these orbits could sweep over such weather events multiple times daily, supporting efforts to predict and lessen storm damage. Satellites in geostationary orbit circle Earth once every 24 hours, appearing fixed from the ground, ideal for broadcasting, internet and telecom services. Plus, nations near the equator, like those in Southeast Asia or South America, benefit most from these orbits, as the satellites focus on their regions rather than drifting over higher latitudes. Next, we dive into our final news story of this week. InnoSpace prepares for its first orbital flight. In a post on X, InnoSpace, a South Korean space startup, are sending their rocket to Brazil for their first orbital flight. The rocket is called the Hanbic Nano and will be flying from the Alcantara Space Center in Brazil. In their post on the X platform, they say, "Our launch pad is heading to Brazil. The journey to InnoSpace's first orbital launch is becoming a reality. The Hanbic Nano launch pad and supply systems are now on their way to the Alcantara Space Center, Brazil. This isn't just about moving hardware. It's a clear sign that we're getting closer than ever to launch day. Every step forward brings us closer to our goal. See you in Brazil." In a previous post, they say, "The launch pad vehicle interface integrated system test for Hanbic Nano has been completed. Our team has validated the independently developed portable launch pad for its mechanical and electrical interfaces. We tested key systems, including the transport erector launcher, umbilical detachment, and hold down mechanism, ensuring technical reliability and operational stability. The launch pad will be shipped to Alcantara Space Center in Brazil starting this April. With this milestone achieved, InnoSpace is moving full speed ahead towards Hanbic Nano's first commercial launch in July. We'll be sure to keep up to date on the progress on this exciting launch from Brazil by InnoSpace." Okay, that's a wrap. Thanks for watching. Space News Live is on Saturday evening or Sunday morning, depending where you watch from. I recap the videos I posted this week, answer questions, respond to comments and chat messages, cover any missed news, and preview upcoming content. I'd love for you to join if you can. Be sure to like and subscribe so you'll see our upcoming videos. We make videos every week covering the space industry, with an emphasis on the smaller space startups that aren't covered so well on other channels. See you soon.